Shifting gears here with names like Penny Hardaway, Larry Finch, Nikki Cray-Penson, George Lapidus. The inaugural class of the Memphis Sports Hall of Fame is one of a kind.
We may need a two-hour show just to go through the list. Here to tell us more about those chosen for this extraordinary honor and what it means for Memphis as a whole, Kevin Kane, who of course is the king of Memphis tourism. How are you, my friend?
I'm doing great, boy. Last night, 200th birthday of the city. What a great day it was. And we announced our inaugural class of the Memphis Sports Hall of Fame, which is going to be located at AutoZone Park.
Which is awesome.
It is awesome.
So Kevin, what does this say about Memphis sports as a whole? Because this really covers the gamut for so many years here.
Well, you know, it's interesting as we're celebrating a bicentennial. Sports, like music, has played a huge role in the history of our city. And think about great Memphis moments and how Memphis sports teams, Memphis sports figures, have influenced our lives. They've brought a lot of joy. They brought a lot of sorrow. You know, we've been up and down, and we've cheered our team on. We've cheered our players on. Even players like Claude Humphreys, who will go in the class this year, the great player at Lester High School, who played 13 seasons in the NFL, Pro Bowler, and of course is in the NFL Hall of Fame, a Memphian from right here. So it's really, really exciting, and it's long overdue. You know, absolutely. Most cities have sports Hall of Fames. It's not uncommon to see major cities have these things. And we partnered with the Memphis Redbirds. You know, they have baseball, they have soccer, now they have sports. We're going to soon to have the Memphis Sports Hall of Fame. You know, they're becoming a year-round activity for people to come to that facility to experience something.
And what a great place to have it, because it, in and of itself, a downtown stadium of that sort,
absolutely,
is such a classy venue.
Absolutely.
I mean, that's unusual.
The first class was very diverse. And, you know, for people out there saying, well, how come so-and-so is not in there? They'll be in there. Don't worry. We could have put 100 people in the inaugural class. We cut it off at 22. And it's not a pecking order of 1 through 22. So we're not saying that that someone who comes in next year is any less significant than somebody who was in the first class. We wanted a lot of diversity, and not just diversity with people who are alive and deceased, coaches, contributors like George Lapidus, and athletes themselves. But we wanted diversity from sports perspective. We just didn't want the first class to be all University of Memphis basketball legends. We've got equestrians. We got Miss Taylor from Smith from Germantown, who won two gold medals and won the Pan American Games in horse jumping.
Stories so, we've never heard many of us.
So Kevin, what's the bigger
Memphis
picture?
Memphis Bill Terry, who they had a parade for.
So
in
what's,
baseball,
what's
100,000 people.
What's the bigger picture here? What's the takeaway that you want people who will be able to come to see this, not just one time, but come back time and time again? What do you want them to take away?
Well, first of all, that Memphis has a great, rich sports history. For our young people, they'll have the opportunity when they're at AutoZone Park to see what, when you dedicate yourselves to a sport or to something, what it can do and what the benefits are when you go to the top of your game, so to speak, because most of these people are in other halls of fame. You know, Rochelle Stevens, Dr. Rochelle Stevens now, told us that, you know, this is the 8th Hall of Fame that she's been inducted in. And of course, she's very proud of this one, I might
add.
So you know more about Memphis, arguably, than anyone else. Was there someone in the class or nominated, maybe not yet in the current class, that really surprised you, that maybe you hadn't heard of?
Well, I really was not aware of Memphis Bill Terry. He was a former major league player. He was the last left-handed player to bat over 400 in the National League.
Who did he play for?
I don't even know who he played for. It's a good question. But he's in the Baseball Hall of Fame. He fell in love with a girl and moved to Memphis, and he became known in the major leagues as Memphis Bill. So that's how he got to Memphis.
Wow. That's so cool.
He wasn't born in, a lot of these athletes aren't born in Memphis.
Right.
Obviously, some of them came through here.
For example, Kevin, is there a possibility we'll see somebody like Bo Jackson?
We very easily could.
Who played for the Memphis Chicks.
He did have a moment where he was in Memphis. We've talked about Bo Jackson.
And he has a great backstory, which is unique. I don't know if it's unique to Memphis, but one of the coolest things about Memphis is there is always a story, you know?
No question about it. And in the Hall of Fame, Mary Beth, we are going to do that. We're going to, this is going to be very digitally driven, which is the way museums in the 21st century are going.
So this will be interactive
eventually?
Absolutely.
It'll be interactive, but we'll be able to tell stories and show video and show clips of great Memphis sports moments, like the Lewis Tyson fight, heavyweight championship fight of the world.
Well, right there.
The Tigers in 1973 going to the national championship game at that classic moment with Bill Walton and UCLA.
Will it also show some of the non-sports, but like one of the coolest things about Penny's story, obviously he had to be in the Hall of Fame.
Absolutely.
But the fact that he came back really to give back and volunteered to help his old coach, will that kind of thing be
No question about it. And, you know, there's people like John Bramlett who are not in this first class. We know John Bramlett will be in the Hall of Fame. But, you know, the John Bramlett story is an unbelievable story.
Yeah.
And so we will tell those stories about Memphians. And quite honestly, when we tell the story in the Hall of Fame, we're going to be telling stories about people that aren't even inducted yet.
Wow.
So
wow.
It will be a comprehensive look.
And from a personal standpoint, from WREG, of course, you're honoring George Lapidus.
And very well deserved. You know, a lot of people don't remember. George was athletic director at Rose College. I mean, he helped bring baseball back. And, you know, I think he was really the one who nudged Dean Jernigan to get, you know, to really be thinking about a downtown stadium and all those things. And
I didn't know that.
Oh, yeah. He was, you know, George was an agent.
George could stay after you.
No question about
it.
Also, Larry Finch. Right,
naturally,
side by side with Larry Finch, Ronnie Robinson,
and we thought that was important because you know, without Larry, you wouldn't have Ronnie. Without Ronnie, you might not have Larry. I mean, those two were really a tandem. They were two kids from Memphis, at Melrose High School that stayed in Memphis just 2-3 years after the Dr. King assassination, when our city was kind of, you know, floundering a little bit.
Yeah.
And they stayed in Memphis and transformed the University of Memphis State at the time, but really brought our city together. I mean, you could argue that they had as much to do with healing in race relations as any minister, any civil rights worker, leader. Yeah. I mean, think about that, what Larry and Ronnie did for the city.
And they could have gone elsewhere.
They could have gone anywhere, no question.
Yeah.
You seem so passionate about this. You really
You know, I'm passionate about Memphis music and I'm passionate about Memphis sports because it's really the musicians and the athletes have really kind of been kind of woven into our lives as Memphians. They've kind of played a role in our life like Penny. We all feel like Penny's a relative of ours, right?
Yeah.
I mean, everybody feels that way.
Absolutely.
And everybody's so proud of Penny and pulling for Penny to succeed. But that's what Memphians do.
So when can folks go and enjoy the
Memphians? Well, you know, yesterday we just announced the class.
Right.
And the induction ceremony will be at AutoZone Park in the fall. We have not established a date yet because we're trying to work out around schedules of honorees who are living that are going to be honored, so we got to get the date right. And but the exhibit itself will start to roll out the latter part of 2019, and it'll be kind of going in phases. We still got a little money to raise on that. We've raised some money. We got to raise a little more, but it's going to be on the third floor of AutoZone Park in about 10,000 square feet of space, and it's going to be a great story. It's going to be free to the public when there's not sporting events going on. Now, when 901 FC or the Memphis Redbirds, you'll have to have a ticket, obviously.
Yeah, but you get a two-for-one
You
deal.
Get a two-for-one, but it's going to be something that I think the community's going to be very proud of, and what we like about it, it's a great visitor amenity as well, so tourists will like it, too.
Absolutely.
I think a lot of people will say this is long overdue.
Absolutely.
For sure.
That is so great. Thank you so much.
Kevin Kane, always good to see you.
Thank you.